Hello all the lovely people out there. Welcome back to another watercolor tutorial on Ayush paper. My name is Simran and I'm a watercolor and a gouache artist based in Pune, India. I am also a Skillshare teacher and you can find my classes on Skillshare. I have classes on both watercolor and gouache as well. So today we'll be painting a beautiful pond with the koi fish. Let's look at the materials we'll be needing for this painting. First, I'll be using a 270 GSM 100% cotton watercolor sketchbook by Ayush paper. Choosing the right paper is very important as paper matters to me. We'll be using watercolor brushes by Silver Black Velvet. I'll be using three sizes mainly, size 10, 6 and 4. I'll be using watercolors by White Knights, Mugello and Daniel Smith. I have my color palette ready. Detailed list of materials is mentioned in the description box below, so you can go ahead and check that out. And let's get started. I have already taped down my paper using a washi tape. And I have also sketched the koi fish and a few lotus leaves. I'll start by applying a coat of water to the paper. I'll only apply the water in the pond area, which means I am going to leave the lotus leaves and the koi fish. Once you've applied an even coat of water, we will start by using some Salo Blue by Daniel Smith. Now I'll be using a lot of Salo Blue and the blues, obviously, because it's a pond. And I'm going to start with the lightest tone of the color. I have added more water to my Salo Blue and I'll start applying that to the pond. As I come closer to the leaves, the leaf area I want it to be a little green, so I'll mix some sap green and some viridian green with the blue and add it to the water. Please make sure that you are working very fast when you are applying the first layer, at least, because since we are using the wet on wet technique, we need to work a lot more faster compared to the other techniques as the paper starts drying really fast. Hence, I would recommend that even you use 100% cotton paper so that your paper doesn't dry too fast. It also depends on the weather conditions in your area, but ideally using 100% cotton paper is much better than using a cellulose paper with like 25% cotton. I am just applying the colors quite randomly. I will also add in some Prussian blue. So the areas near the fish would be slightly dark because I want it to look like a little popped up, which means I want to sort of indicate a 3D effect. That's why I'm just going to, or a shadow effect. That's why I'm just going to use the darkest blue near the fish area, only on one side of the fish. And I'm just going to blend that with water. So we don't actually need to see any harsh lines or add any harsh lines. Everything that we do in the pond is going to be with light hands and it'll have a lot of soft strokes. I'm going to repeat the process of painting the pond till I finish painting and till I get the desired outcome. It's absolutely okay if your painting doesn't look like what I am doing. You just have to enjoy the process of painting and learning how to paint the koi fish. Believe me, even I was as scared as you are right now when you were watching the video on how to paint a koi fish. I have never painted a koi fish before and this was my first attempt. I'm literally happy with how this entire painting turns out at the end. And that's why I'm going to encourage you to also give it a try, even though you feel it's a little difficult. But just go ahead and try it out. At least you will know what you need to improve on, right? Also, I get many questions regarding different watercolor techniques or, you know, which material should be used as a beginner, because there are so many products in the market and it's but natural that anyone would, you know, sort of feel overwhelmed by what to use and how to use. Your one-stop solution to this is the website that is launched by Ayush Paper, ask.ayushpaper.com. This website, believe me, has answers to all your queries. And this website is basically made for the artist, by the artists. So you'll be able to interact with a lot of different artists all over the globe as well. The website helps you interact with a lot of different artists all over the globe, which will also sort of give you an exposure to the different art forms throughout the globe. So don't forget to go ahead and check that out. Once we are done with applying the blues and the greens to the water area, we will just give it a minute or two for the paper to dry completely. Only then we'll start working on the koi fish. Otherwise, everything will become blue and orange and red, which we don't want. So let's just wait for a few minutes and then we can come back and start with the koi fish. So the water area has dried completely and now I'm going to start with the koi fish. Koi fish, I'm going to start by using a light gray color. I'm doing this only on the borders of the fish, also only on one side, just to sort of balance that 3D effect or the shadow that we are looking for. So for the gray, I'm going to mix some crimson, some Prussian blue and some black together. And I'm going to add lots of water to this color, as I want the gray to be light as well and not too vibrant. So particularly I'm using this gray because it also has like a little bit, you know, purplish tone to it, which will sort of match with the colors of the pond. So I'm going to start by adding that color on the edges, or you can say to the border of the fish. Once I apply that color, I'm going to blend it with the water. Now when I'm blending the color with the water, I'll make sure that I'm not covering the entire fish with the same color, as we want a lot of vibrant colors as well. And if we do this, then you know, the colors that we'll use later won't pop out that much. I'm going to do the same thing to both the fishes, and I'm just going to blend it and be very, very soft on my hands when I'm doing this. Once I'm done with this, I'm going to take some orange and I'll start adding it to one of the fishes. So there is no fixed or definite way to paint a koi fish. You just have to keep the colors in mind and, you know, how they work around themselves. That's it. I'm just going to add a few orange and a few yellows and a few reds to the fishes. That's it. And you don't even have to sort of blend the colors too much, as each color has to sort of stand out on its own. You can also leave a few white spaces. So you can actually go ahead and Google, you know, the koi fish, so that you get like a rough idea as to how does the fish look like. And this will help you to understand where to add the colors, how much white space to leave. Once we are done with painting the fishes, we will just let them dry a little. Just wait for like 30 to 45 seconds. Till then you can just make a dark black color. So I'm not going to use black directly as it will become too dark for the fish. I am going to go ahead and mix some Prussian blue and some black together, and I'm just going to add a few border, you know, like border highlights to the fishes. Once we are done with that, I'm gonna make some dark blue color. I'm just gonna mix some Prussian blue and some black together, and I'm gonna add it to the water. So I'm gonna add this to the area near the fish where we had already added the dark tone. I am just going to highlight that using this dark blue color, and I'm just going to try to blend it with some water. I'm going to do this with both the fishes. Once we are done with that, I'll go ahead and start painting the leaves. So for the leaves, I'll be using the wet on dry technique, and I'll start by applying some yellow to all the leaves. Then I'm going to mix some sap green and some black together. And I'll start applying that color, and I'll merge it with the yellow as well. So by the time the leaves are drying so that we can go ahead and add the details, we'll start adding a few ripples to the pond. So for the ripples, I'm using a dark blue color again, and I'm just making a few C strokes to indicate the ripples. Once I add the strokes, I'll also blend it with some clean water. And I'm also going to make a few ripples with the dark green color. Once we are done with the ripples, it's time to add the details to the leaves. For this, I'm using a dark green color and I'm just going to border all the leaves and add a vein. So our painting is ready and I hope you've enjoyed painting this beautiful pond scene. Make sure you remove the masking tape or the washi tape only after the painting has dried completely. We would love to see your recreations. So do DM us with what you've created on Instagram at Ayush Paper. And we are going to see you soon with another video. Until then, happy painting.